I'll keep asking her. Are you coming out, Lily? Hey? No. Then I close the door. And then it's like, I don't want to come out, but don't close my door, Mum. So, which one is it? Are you coming out? Are you actually gonna come out and say hello today? Or you just want your door left open for the day? Which one is it? That's the camera. You're blurred. You're totally blurred. And that's a finger at the side, which you cannot have. Okay? So, are you going to come out? Nope. What are you doing hiding your head down? Oh, did you drop a mouse? Nope. No mouse dropped. Come on, Lily. There is no way you are starving. Hey. But I'm not getting Lily to move. Jessie is and has been laying in that position for ages. Hey, bud. But Lily, will you come on out? Hey, shall I open the door? Come on. Come and say hello. Are you going to? Oh, I don't know. I do not know. Is it? Well, she's not coming out. She's not coming out. No, of course she's not coming out. That'll be when I'm starting to turn off all the lights and I want to go to bed. That's when Lily will want to come out. Well, I'm asking Lily to come out and play. Do you want to come and play, Lily? Today? Your belly is full, my sweetie pie. So hang on, I'm just viewing a video I've yet to actually put up. So
because I see other coastals.
I'll pause that and I'll put my blind up. I have been out all morning and I truly dislike it. Otherwise Lily would have probably have been out so much earlier, hey, wouldn't you? Hey, mama girl. But I've only just got home, sweetie. So you're more than welcome to come and spend some time with me today. Jessie and Jack have got full bellies, so Lily's will be quite digested. Hey, my darling. Do you plan on coming out today? I'm pretty sure that you will. It's not very often I have to do much coaxing to get Lily to decide to come out. You know, and that's been probably a little bit about my videos too. You know, Jessie, yeah, I have to physically go in at today, still today, after, you know, 2 years. Sometimes I haven't. Trust me, there are times when he's at that door and he wants out, and out he comes. But more often than not, I end up having to get Jesse out. And I think that may be related to him being not so comfortable out. He's much more comfortable in there. But anyway, he has absolutely got a full belly. Not that you would think it by that expression of, I'll take a mouse, thank you very much. If that's available to me today, thank you. As I said, Jesse is growing. He is just growing. So I'm amazed at just how much he has actually grown in this last couple of months. he's such a sweetie. For a stunner, he's a sweetie. And Lily, what up? Do you plan on coming out? She said, well, I wish you'd. Why have you always got that black thing in your hand? Because you are beautiful. You are a beautiful girl. Yes, you are. Are you coming out? No, not yet. Oh, you help. Hopeful of some mice too, are you? What is it with you guys? You don't always have something to eat, you know. Now, Lily had 8 mice, so, you know, I think I've said in another video, as I've not put it up yet, but she maybe could have had the 10, but I think 8 was plenty enough, and I think Lily's just making up on lost time for that 3 or 4 months where she didn't eat. So, but she certainly didn't lose weight or any of her condition whatsoever. You know, I took her to the vet, and the vet actually said she's overweight. I was like, what? Yeah, she's a little bit chubby there. So certainly that having not eaten was maybe a good thing, because I certainly do not want overweight snakes. It does lessen their life, and I'm not into, you know, make them big either. My guys are going to be plenty big enough. You know, I love the big snakes. I don't know what it is about them. I just love them. And jungles aren't in the category of being the littlest, but they're not exactly the biggest. Actually, our coastals are the biggest species. So, you know, Jack might only be a little boy, and he may not be within the category of one of the biggest coastals ever, but he's still got a lot of growing to do too. So he's gonna be big soon enough. Well, Lily, I'll just leave your door open as I do, sweetie, and you let me know. I'm sure that you'll be out, but I am on a bit of a time frame, darling, so don't leave it too long. All right, I will hopefully get a little bit of Lily out. Can't guarantee anything, because she may and she may not. that's long and thin. I can climb on that.
Oh, my goodness, girl. No fear. Like,
who says that they're fearful, that they're easily stressed or... Anyway, she's got a good grip on me tripod there. But... she came down to actually check it out to see, yeah, what are you doing? Even though she's been around my neck that many, not around my neck, but hanging off me while I've been doing the vacuuming. But it's all curiosity. It is certainly not fear. Yep, she can sense the vibrations of it, but she can also hear the sound of it. She can see the movement of it. So, but certainly not afraid of it. So, you know, they say that snakes are easily stressed and, well, have I just been the one that's gotten lucky? And my snakes don't stress about these sorts of things? Because I don't think that's the case, really. So, you know, I do so much with Lily, and she has no fear, and that is a picture of a happy, calm, relaxed snake while I'm doing the vacuuming, walking around her, bumping. Yeah. Hey Lily, you're not afraid of nothing. Except maybe me bumping her nose. And then it's, I think, like us, reflex. Not fear, just reflex. That there's something, you know, bumping me on my nose. And that's about it. So yeah, I just thought I'd put that clip in and just to say, you know, they don't fear. If they know you, they know their space, they know where they are, etc. What have they got to fear? Absolutely nothing. No harm's ever come to them. They've never been hurt here. Nothing's ever happened. They know it's, you know, it's almost, well, it's not going to happen. So, totally chilled out. Hey, Lily. Anything to be out, I think, too, for Lily. Ciao. Lily thinks she can do anything, but you know, that hasn't got a very wide ledge on it, this TV, and she gets the wobbles, but you know, she thinks she can do it, and hopefully she will decide to turn back, but not Lily. She gives it her best shot, you know, and I watch her get so far and then she starts to wobble, although she's now got this painting between the wall and this ledge, so she kind of slots herself into there, and I don't know where she thinks she's actually going to go once she actually gets to the end. But, you know, this is why we keep our eye on our guys, because they don't always know what is best, and can they and will that, and, you know, will they be safe? They don't always do know what's best for them. So, I am going to have to, no doubt, stop this camera and probably, I don't know, I've never really allowed her to do the whole thing. I just think she'll go down the back of that TV and I don't want her to do it. Okay, so now the bit more frantic of you're taking too long to open the door. Honestly, Lil, how do I get anything done in the morning with you? It's impossible, actually. You know, if Lily was a snake that came out and was like Jack, for example, and just chilled out and was happy to just hang. And pretty much stay in one spot, so to speak. But I tell you what, carpets are really not known for that. They tend to be so curious and move. So if you don't want a snake that constantly is on the go, then carpet pythons, I tell you, are probably not the way you want to go, to be honest, because you do have to be prepared to be on the go with them and watch them, because they can be quick, fast, determined. The determination to do as they want to do. That's carpet pythons, and that's Lily. Yeah, a lot of times she makes out, no, I'm not going over there. No, I'm not going to do that. And that's exactly what she's going to do. Lulls me into a false sense of security, don't you, Lily? Hey? Yes, I see you. And what's your plan today? Because going up in the hangout spot, as much as she makes a way up there, it's of late, no, I'm not going to hang up here. I'll just go up and have a little bit of a look around. Then I'll come back down and then I'll go to all those places, Mum, where I know you don't like me to go. Hey, I put you on the jungle gym of late and you're straight down on the floor. Hey. She knows where the jungle gym is and makes her way to it and goes to it. You coming up? You coming up to say hello? So I can't get to you past that darn camera these days. So yep, away she goes. Jack is coming out today, whether Jack wants to or Jack don't want to. He's going to be venturing out and I'm going to be rearranging. She's going to go visit the dogs. He says, wait, here's more like, I don't move the no snake, basically. And you can go up here, maybe. It's okay, Jack, you can stay there. It's okay, buddy. Shake hands. Good boy. You need some love too, don't you? Hey, you need some love too? What about you, Mol? You need some love? Yeah, not all about snakes in my house either. With the dogs, how's your ear? Jed always gets sore ears this time of the year, so he needs constant drops. You do, don't you? Good boy, aren't you? Yeah, look at Lil. Look at Lily. I know. Yeah, I've got to switch the air off. I've still got the fan going. But, you know, it's like 28 in this room at the moment. So, you know, warm enough certainly for Lily to be out and exploring. But, you know, us humans need that air conditioning going because it's hot. It is really hot. So, actually, the room temperature is almost 29. So, you know, I do have to keep my eye on the temps inside the enclosures this time of the year. Because Jack's cool end can hit that 29. So, even lowering his heating within his enclosure, it still gets to a high temp. So, I have to get that air conditioning going and cool the room down. So, yep, my little Miss Mischief. She's got lots of names, I know. You know, I guess it's not mischief. It's curiosity. But within that curiosity, it's mischief. She gets into mischief. You know, Jack would come out, and he does go down. But Jack will get to the end of that couch line, turn around, and come back into this room. He doesn't venture under the couches. He doesn't go behind things. He just doesn't. Lily, there's no boundaries. It's just wherever I can go, wherever I can fit, wherever I can sneak to, Lily does it. It's yes, here she is. Is it not? So I'll quickly go and flick this air conditioning on in the other room for Jed, so he can lay down somewhere where it's cool, and I'm sure Lily will be perfectly fine until I get back. I'm just 2 seconds away. From her. Right, Jet. On with the air, bud. Alright?
Yeah.
Jet. Noah's here doing his things.
Call Judy.
The air's on in the other room, bud. I'm as hot as you are. And Lily, of course, is saying, "Yeah, what's wrong with you? Temps are good, Mum. Stop complaining." So I said, "But our summers are fabulous in terms of, you know, we can get our guys out. We know that they're comfortable. But honestly, during the day, even at morning, outside, that sun is really, really, really hot, so you intend to sort of take these guys out. If at any time it would be at 4 p.m. and after, and it's starting to sort of cool off a little bit. So where are we going today, Lily?" I said, "Lily don't care. Lily is such a confident snake. You know, she's fearless, I think, actually. She will go anywhere. And it certainly is not stressful to her or I don't even know how to explain that. You know, does she look fearful? Does she look stressed? Does she look like she's just tolerating being here? I don't think so. She is happy and curious. And wears me out. Oh. Lily, you're going into the dark, darling. At this time of the morning, it's pretty dark over there. So what's over there? Well, she knows what's over there, ultimately.
Hey? Stand the right up wise.
Are you coming? Checking out. It's cold over this side. I've just put the air conditioning on. You do not want to come here. Yeah, she's getting a big girl, Lily. But not heavy. Just long. Where are you gonna go? Oh, is she still in view? Yep. Here, Mum, sit. I'll sit here. Hey, dog. You coming? Go out of Zoom. And of course, well, now I'll go under the couch. No. Up the couch. Goodness, Jed. Lily Lou. This away. Come this away. Ooh, that's easy. She just slippery slides across the floor. Woo! Where are you gonna go? Well, I'm going to leave her to go on her little adventure, but back into the other room. It's a bit hard sitting on this floor and not easy for me to get back up again either. Hey, Lil. This is not a one-handed job, but she could sit round my shoulders while I drive, mow the lawns, do my shopping. Lily would be the snake to do it. So Now I'm going to say ciao so I can get her and get her back into the room with me. And now you're going up on the table. Like, whew. All right, ciao.